Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to sharpen your image and how to make the image look beautiful when you sharpen it. So if you look at this image, the image looks somehow blur. The reason the image is like this is because I use the noise effect on my image and I also use the skin smoothing process, and it kind of blur the image and I don't like the result. So to sharpen your image, you need to know different steps to sharpen the image. The first step I'll be showing you is to go to filter. So if you head to filter, you can click on sharpen and just select sharpen. So this is the local method of sharpening your image, but I will not be using this local method of sharpening the image. So I'm just going to press Ctrl Z to go back. And the first thing you have to do now is to press Ctrl J on your keyboard, which is to create a new layer. Remember, when you're editing your image in Photoshop, anytime you're editing your image, you have to press Ctrl J on your keyboard. So once you have pressed that Ctrl J on your keyboard, the next thing you have to do is to go to desaturate. So we want to desaturate by removing the colors in the image. So you have to go to image, adjustment, then you look for desaturate. And if you just click on the desaturate, you are just going to see that your image is going to change. So once the image has changed, as in once you have removed all the colors by desaturating it, the next thing you have to do is to convert that layer one to smart object. So just right click on it, then you select convert to smart object. And once you are done converting it to smart object, the next thing you have to do is to go to filter, order, then you select high pass. So for this high pass, you have to leave your radius to be 2.0. And once you are done, just hit OK. Click on this layer one. Then change the blending mode to linear light. You have to change the blending mode to linear light. And if you see, it has become more sharp. This is the before. This is the after. You can see the result. Let's zoom in the image. This is the before. And this is the after. But the sharpening effect has affected all the parts of the image. It affects the hair. It affects the background. It affects the lips and the rest. But we don't want it to affect everywhere. So the next thing you have to do is to create a black layer mask or a negative layer mask. So to create this negative layer mask, you have to hold Alt on your keyboard, Alt on your keyboard first. Move your mouse or your cursor to this area, which is layer mask. So if you click on it, you'll be able to add a black layer mask or a negative layer mask. Once I've created that negative layer mask, the effect or the sharpening effects will just disappear from our image. Now the next thing you have to do is to select your brush. Once you select your brush, you can reduce the size of your brush. You can increase the flow if you like and reduce the opacity of this layer. Just click on it, go to the opacity, and you can reduce the opacity to be around 61 or 48. Click on the black layer first. Make sure your foreground color is white, and if the foreground color is white, you'll be able to use your brush to apply that effect on your image. But if the foreground color is black, look at what I'm showing you at this area. Look at the left hand side of your screen. If the foreground color is black, you'll be able to remove that effect from the picture. Now, if you want to see what you are doing, you can go to channels. Just click on channels, then you turn on this layer. You can see layer one max. If you turn it on, just turn on the eye symbol, you'll be able to see the effect, as in where you are applying that effect on. Now this thing can work with any layer that has a layer max on it. You can just go to channels and turn it on, and if you turn it on, you can be able to apply it. Now there's a short code here for it. This is the short code here for it. That's if your keyboard has not been changed before. If you are using an original system, the short code is this symbol here. So once you turn it on, you'll be able to see the places that you're applying the sharp effect on. I'm sharpening the skin of the image. You can see what's happening to our image. I can sharpen this area. and also sharpen this area. So I don't need to sharpen any other parts of our image. If you want to remove this red thing on your image, just go to channels and turn it off and you'll be able to remove it. Now that red thing is used to see where you are brushing on your image and where you have not touched on your image, so you don't make mistake. Since this effect is not very harsh on the image, that you can't see where you have touched and where you have not touched. Now let's look at the before and the after. This is the before, this is the after. Let's zoom in our image. You can see that our image has become more sharp using this, our skin sharpening process. Now, another thing is that you can get this skin sharpening process in my magic retouching pack. If you go to actions, you will see skin texture. This is it here. You will see skin texture 16-bit. But the name is not supposed to be skin texture. It's supposed to be skin sharpening. Why this skin texture for 16-bit is the main skin texture action if you want to bring out the texture of your skin. So if you get this magic retouching pack, Dirty Studio Magic Retouching Pack, you'll be able to get all the list of my 40 Photoshop actions, professional actions that you can use to edit your image. As a photographer, if you don't have this magic retouching pack, I promise you that you're missing a lot, because in my videos, in my future videos, I'll also be talking about this magic retouching pack. And I'll also make a special video also on how you can use this magic retouching pack. That is if I've not yet uploaded it. You can check my previous videos to see if there's a video there, or you can check my future videos to see if I have uploaded the video. But I've already made the video especially for the magic retouching pack. So if you get this magic retouching pack, you'll see all the list of my action. You see dodge and burn, you'll see rich skin tone, you'll see light contrast, many of these action. Click the link in the description of this video to get the magic retouching pack. And the price is just going to increase in future. So if you are watching this video, you have to get your own faster now. The next thing that I'll be showing you is that how you can sharpen your image using another part of Photoshop. Let's just delete this, our skin sharpening process that we just did. So once I delete it, you will see that our image is no more sharpening again. It has become somehow blur. So the next thing you have to do is to press Ctrl J on your keyboard. Remember, this is the third process that I'm showing you on how you can sharpen your image. The first process I told you about was going to filter and selecting sharpen, then sharpen, or you select sharpen more. The second process is that effect that I just did on our image that I told you that you can get it through Dirty Studio Magic Retouching Pack. You can just click on it. And one good thing about this action is that you don't have to waste too much time while creating the process. Let me just show you what I'm talking about. If I just click on this skin texture, which is this skin sharpening process, and I just start painting on our image, you can see what's happening to the image. Is becoming more sharp. You don't need to follow those long process again. So the third method that I'll be showing you is using the camera raw filter. To open your camera raw filter, you have to press Ctrl Shift A on your keyboard. Let me just press it and show you. Ctrl Shift and A on my keyboard, and you see that the camera raw filter section is just going to open. Now if you don't want to follow through this process, which is a short process, you can go to filter and you select camera raw filter. So if you go to filter and select camera raw filter, your camera raw filter section is just going to open. So once the camera raw filter section open, you can go to details first. Now for the sharpening of this area, you can increase the sharpening to be around, let's say, 18. Once the sharpening is at 18, we need to do some adjustments also. So you just turn it off, and then go to your effects. So once you click on effects, you will see clarity and you will see texture. For this clarity, you bump your clarity to 30, and for the texture, I'm just going to bump it to be around 17. So I'm just going to increase the texture to be around 17. And once I'm done with this camera raw filter, I'm just going to click OK. And you can see the results of our image. Look at the result. Our image has now become more clear using the camera raw filter. This is the before, this is the after. You can see that it brings out the clarity of our image. It also helps us bring out the texture of the image. This is why the camera raw filter is one of the most important section of Photoshop, or one of the best features of Photoshop that you need to always use while editing your picture. And we are done with this tutorial. Thank you for watching. If this video was very helpful to you, subscribe for more videos, turn on notifications so YouTube will notify you when I upload a new video, and leave a like to help the channel out.